So I think the expectation is that they should bring about that change. The finance minister in his budget speech also mentioned that he will bring about a notification which will say that if you are repatriating your money out of India, which is chargeable to tax, and if that is being repatriated outside India, then we will bring in some kind of an exemption. So the expectation is that that will be worded wide enough to cover most of the cases. You will not have any ambiguities there. So that's one expectation. And as well as the second expectation is that they have made the change in long-term capital gain, the treatment of long-term capital gain. I mean, while the law remains as it is, there's no major change, but the manner in which they have bought in that change, they're saying that you have to pay STT on the buy side and you have to pay STT on the sell side. Only then you qualify for the long-term capital gain exemption. And they have said that for genuine transactions, we will bring out a notification. We will say that, say for example, it's an IPO or if it's a rights share, right? And you don't pay STT on the buy side. We will bring out a notification which says that those transactions are out of this ambit of this provision. Now, the expectation is that when they bring out that notification, it will be clear enough to cover all the possible cases, right? I think the concern, and in the past, maybe the experience has not been so good. Maybe my expectation now is that they will probably follow the same consultative approach. They will say that, okay, please, as investors, please list down what are the scenarios which are possible, and then come out with that notification. Right. So I think those are the big ones, but there are multiple other small expectations, but then I'll just not bother.
What would you, Mr. Chauhan? Yeah. What would you say? I mean, you gave us a lot of insight into various changes and things which have happened, but a couple of other things which is in your wish list as a, not as a lawyer, but...
At times, because of lack of clarity or ambiguity in the interpretation of regulations, most of these disputes, they crop up and all. Now, here we have this, SEBI has one scheme called informal guidance scheme, wherein, let's say, any potential queries you have, you can make an application to SEBI and seek their guidance on those. Now, if you see the scheme of those informal guidance, you'll find that they take around 60 days to give that guidance to you, the moment they receive your application seeking guidance and all. Now, that 60 days is on statute book, but then at times, invariably, it gets stressed to further 2 or 3 months down the line. Now, in this age, let's say some transaction is going on and some immediate kind of interpretation is required, then you can't afford to wait for another 60 days or so. And then, in such like situations, what people do is they will just go ahead, say a little prayer and move ahead. And thereafter, we'll see subsequently, in case if anything goes wrong, then we'll have to litigate. That's the only choice left with them and all. So in that context, I mean, that's a suggestion. I mean, the thought was that in case if they can fast track this procedure. Now, typically here, they charge around 25,000 for giving this informal guidance. So we can have some expedited procedure, let them charge a higher fees and all, and try to give that guidance as fast as possible, maybe a week or maybe 15 days or so. That will immensely help all these transactions.
Tatkal scheme.
Yeah, Tatkal scheme, even for passports and all, if you have to obtain in an expedited fashion, you pay a higher amount and get it done. Similarly, from the perspective of securities market and all, let's say if some live transaction is going on and some kind of point crops up, which has earlier not been traversed, or maybe there is some kind of ambiguity, point has not been traversed earlier, definitely everybody will need guidance for that part. And even the regulations also don't envisage all kind of potential situations which may crop up and all. In such kind of situations, if transaction is very imminent, then this guidance is required immediately and all. And then second point is whatever guidance which comes, that also is very guarded, very what you call tentative and not very straight. So on that score, because ultimately, in case if this guidance are given swiftly and in a very proper fashion, that will eradicate the potential disputes which may crop up in future, insofar as entities are concerned and all. This was from the interpretation side, lack of clarity. Second is with regard to resolution of disputes. Here we have actually SEBI Act itself contemplates various multifarious proceedings which can be taken against this intermediaries or maybe investors in the market, let's say if they violate laws and all. So 2-3 actions which are there, like this whole time members are there, they will initiate proceedings and they will debar the entities and all. They have the powers to disgorge amounts also, illicit profits in case of the parties have made. And parallelly, you have this adjudication officers who impose monetary penalties and all. Now, typically in most of the cases, what happens is regulator starts both the proceedings together. So you have this same proceeding going on before this whole time member on identical facts, and parallelly and concomitantly, this adjudicating officers are also adjudicating on the same set of facts and all. Let's say if there is a time lag between the conclusion of both the proceedings, whole time member holds one thing on a particular this thing, similarly adjudicating officer also holds, let's say, at variance with whole time member and all. That gives rise to unnecessary conflict and all. So suggestion was that in case if monetary penalties are to be imposed, because the statute requires it has to be done by adjudicating officer, if the statute is amended to the effect that the whole time member who is conducting the proceedings, he can also impose monetary penalty there and then. So you don't have to unnecessarily appoint another parallel adjudicating officer and give rise to multiplicity of proceedings. So that can be avoided. And let's say in a given case, if they want to just impose monetary penalty and not take any other action, then only adjudicating officer is appointed. So in those like cases, what will happen is there will be only one proceeding which will come to the fore. Otherwise, you have on the same set of facts two proceedings going on. Then on the second aspect was with regard to the settlement process. Idea is very laudable, but unfortunately we find while interacting with intermediaries in the market that even intermediaries themselves are not aware about this settlement part and all. Recently we had a case the other day that the order has been passed. Now the intermediary, when they approached us, when we told them that okay, these were very technical objections, you could have easily filed a settlement process, they said they were not aware about it. So certain amount of work has to be done on this creation of awareness insofar as this settlement process is concerned. And one good example for that could be that whenever these notices are issued, in those notices itself, this provision with regard to the settlement can be intimated to the potential notices and all. In case if that is intimated, I'm sure most of the matters, in case if they are of that nature, I mean very technical nature and all, they will get sorted out there and then, because no intermediary in the market really wants to litigate against the regulator as such. And then third point was with regard to this Securities Appellate Tribunal. Now, with the merging of this this commodities market into SEBI, now all those appeals with regard to them, they will also come before SAT. Now we have this insurance-related appeals. Insurance will also come under the umbrella of Securities Appellate Tribunal. Then you have this pension fund also. Those related appeals will also come before the Securities Appellate Tribunal. So as on date, we have already one bench in Mumbai for handling all these kind of appeals. So there, I think in my view, there is a dire need for creation of this multiple benches and all, maybe across India, for handling all these kind of matters. Even recently, I mean, in this various budgets, for last 2-3 budgets and all, sounds have been made by this finance ministers with regard to creation of this multiple benches, but the proposals have still not fructified. Once they fructify, that will also ease the burden, because other day there was this report in the newspapers as such that this SAT is truly burdened with a lot of cases. That is a function because not adequate benches are there and all.